A thick blanket of toxic smog continues to engulf Delhi and the National Capital Region. After a brief respite, pollution levels have spiked again, air quality remaining hazardous and poisonous in most parts of the National Capital. The particulate matter count remains alarmingly high even this morning, despite the fact that several measures have reportedly been put in place. Today, the Arvind Kejriwal government will once again make an attempt for the implementation of the odd-even plan. They're appealing at the National Green Tribunal to exempt two-wheelers and automobiles driven by women drivers.
The pollution is a lot, okay? So, usse kya hai ki aap jab breathe karoge aapko bahut sari diseases ho sakti hai respiratory. So that's the reason we are wearing the mask. Abhi school aana zaruri hai, isliye jab abhi bata rahe hain bahut pollution hai, is wajah se abhi mask laga ke rakha hai aur jab tak rahega tab tak lagana padega.
India Today's Shalini Lobo joins us from Akshardham. Ilma Hassan joins us from the India Gate. Shalini, to you first. The current situation, the steps that the Delhi government says they've taken, have they had any result whatsoever?
Well, Gaurav, I'm at Vijay Chowk right now, and as you can see, a huge thick layer of fog behind me, smog behind me. This is how it is. Now, the Delhi government has initiated where they've got fire trucks brought into the national capital and the toxic areas. They've been using these fire trucks to spray water on the trees and on the road so that the dust particles suspended in air settle down. This is one initiative that they've taken. Another initiative is the odd-even plan, which they're looking forward to implementing, provided the NGT gives them a go signal for exemptions that they're asking for. Exemptions of women who will be driving alone in their cars, exemptions also for two-wheelers. But however, the NGT said you can go ahead with your plan minus these exemptions, but the Delhi government seems that this is the only way out. They need these exemptions in place because crime against women, according to them, is not something you can turn a blind eye to in the national capital. There are talks of having a sprinkling system in Delhi where they want to put in sprinklers, they want to sprinkle water over the city through helicopters. However, that's also at a standstill right now, and the political blame game just keeps going on. But the likes of you and me, even though we do our little that we can, we get caught in this mess.
Got okay, it. So Ilma, the situation on ground where you are, the steps that Delhi government was supposed to take, whether bring in helicopters, so that's clearly not happening in a day or two, but to use vacuum trucks on the road, to use water to clean tires, to prohibit entry of trucks, how many of those steps have actually been implemented on ground, and to what effect?
Well, Gaurav, what they have been doing is using fire engines to sort of get the smog to settle down. Additionally, they've also been using vacuum trucks on Delhi roads. Honestly, we've been covering this since last year, and we're covering this year as well. The steps taken last year were much quicker, and it seems like this time the Delhi government is a little slow in terms of the action that it is taking. Considering the fact that this time also the schools were shut 3 to 4 days after, the smog really got to a hazardous, dangerous level is an indication of that. The fact that schools are open today is also an indication of that, Gaurav. Additionally, they've asked for the odd-even plan to be implemented, but that is something that is going to be discussed in the NGT later today as well. You've had the Delhi government also sort of put the blame on the neighboring states in crop burning, which is, according to them, a major factor of the smog and the resultant pollution of it. Low wind speeds just adding to that further. So you've had the Delhi government write to the center, you've had them write to the Punjab chief minister as well. But these are just actions they claim that they are taking. At the end of the day, nothing really has been done. All of these are preventive measures, like shutting down school for a few days for the safety of school kids. Additionally, advising students not to step out,
yes,
like that as well. Getting construction to stop for a few days might, sort of help reduce the pollution a little bit. But as we're seeing in the past few days, it really hasn't resulted in anything at all.
And that's the unfortunate part.
Indicating, looking at the previous time it was implemented, did it really have an impact? It didn't.
Long-term measures. So let's divide the problem into short-term, medium-term and long-term measures. Has the government taken effective steps? Clearly not. And what is that resulting in? Let's show you the ground situation. What is the ground situation at this point of time? We're taking a look at levels of particulate matter in various parts of the national capital. So Anand Vihar is 501. Remember the AQI, the air quality index, safe, restricted to just 50. Anand Vihar is 501. So that's point one. Let's now move a little ahead, Punjabi Bagh. This is one area that sees a lot of trucks coming in, and there it's an alarming 743 from Punjabi Bagh. Let me now take you to Siri Fort in South Delhi. Now, you'd expect there are a lot of trees around Siri Fort. Is it any better? Well, it's 404 that remains hazardous. So not as bad as Punjabi Bagh at 743, but it's 420 in Dwarka in West Delhi. Again, that's hazardous. This is the air that we are breathing in Delhi. Ramkrishnapuram in South Delhi. So there's a flyover under construction, road activity happening, 465. All construction activity has come to a standstill in Delhi. In the heart of Delhi, the income tax office or ITO at 384. Yamuna cleaning, very essential, not happening. Methane gas emission adds to the problem. So this is the situation in the national capital at this stage. And I want to now, once again, cut across to Ilma Hassan. Ilma, you were telling me about steps that the Delhi government has taken, but unfortunately, results not very positive. Why is that, Ilma? Okay, we're having an issue with Ilma's audio. Shalini, the same question. Steps that Delhi government has taken, why isn't the situation improving? Is it because the temperature has just plummeted, or are there other reasons?
Gaurav, one thing we cannot turn a blind eye to is the fact that the Delhi government always seems to wake up late. Now, this is a problem Delhi battles with every single year. And first they said it's because of the fireworks, so let's ban the sale of fireworks to ease out pollution. This Diwali, we saw considerably less amount of fireworks being burst. People were getting aware of it. Children were campaigning on the road. So there was a big say no to fireworks campaign. But despite that, we still had alarming pollution levels. And as you see behind me, a whole layer of smog here in the national capital, still alarming pollution levels, air quality index off the charts. What did the Delhi government do? They said, let's implement an odd even plan. But the thing about the odd even plan that we saw last year, pollution levels did not come down much. It just eased out on traffic congestion. Traffic was running smoothly, but pollution levels still remained the same. Even right now, the Met Department tells us that over the next 2 days, Delhi might see slight rainfall, and that'll ease out the problem. But when will the Aam Aadmi Party implement the odd-even solution if they think that'll bring in slight relief? They still haven't done it. They're still arguing with the NGT, saying that we need exceptions in place. Without the exceptions being in place, we can't implement an odd-even scheme. Apart from that, stopping construction work. Yes, construction work has been stopped. A lot of places in surrounding NCR, in Delhi, next to Ames and Safdarjung, construction is at a standstill. You can just see those skeleton buildings. But the fact is, illegal construction is still happening. We can't turn a blind eye to it.
Absolutely. Shutting schools for 3 days. Clearly, the center and the states, they need to crack down on the illegal activity. They need to step up. They need to come together. Keep tracking that story. Shalini and Ilma Hassan, I will come back to you for more. But this rising pollution and dense smog in Delhi and the NCR, it's a major health hazard, not just for those with respiratory ailments, but even for healthy people. It's making it very difficult to breathe. Let's now take a look at how people are tackling this problem.
He's 70-year-old and an asthma patient. As a war veteran who traveled the length and breadth of the country when serving in the Indian Army, he's accustomed to all kinds of vagaries of the weather. But for the past 2 years since he settled in Delhi post-retirement, the city is choking Lieutenant Colonel Ravindra Singh.
It feels so difficult that I've refrain myself from going out of the house, and I use a purifier, you know. in the house 24/7. And only if it's necessary, if I go and see a doctor or something very essential comes up, then I go out. Otherwise, I'm absolutely confined to my house, jailed, I would say, to the house.
It's that time of the year again when Delhi goes breathless. Toxic pollutants mixed with fog create a thick blanket of smog over the capital sky, making it impossible to take deep breath. It is at this time that your health is at risk too.
In on particulate matter 2.5 and 10, 10 will lead to lung damage and 2.5 will lead to heart damage. Paralysis, heart damage, sudden death, all can come because of 2.5. In a normal population, if you are feeling suffocated, loss of energy, cough, just go to a less polluted area.
Some of the common ailments you could suffer as a result of exposure to this toxic air include cough, wheezing or breathlessness, pneumonia, COPD or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, lung cancer. There are several symptoms of possible health risk that you can watch out for and consult a doctor if they worsen.
These toxins cause swelling in the lining of the windpipe and the lungs, and that predisposes it to all kinds of infections. So stay indoors, avoid any outdoor activity which makes you breathless.
Winter months haven't always been uncomfortable for someone like Lieutenant Colonel Ravindra Singh, who lived most of his life in the hills of Nainital. But Delhi, he says, feels like a death chamber.
Politicians talk basically from vote bank politics side. They should be more practical, more humane, or even how is it going to help? Has it helped in foreign countries like France and other European countries? No. It's not succeeded.
If exposed to this toxic air, then unfortunately there are no preventive measures that you can use in order to mitigate the health risks involved, but you can take some precautions. For instance, if possible, remove yourself immediately from the outdoors environment and move indoors. And if the same's not possible, then wear a mask like this and save yourself from the health hazards involved. With camerapersons Alok Bhatnagar and Anil Jaiswal, Paulami Saha in Delhi for India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.